Beth from rockyournotebook.com/scrappingwonders, and I'm up for the cheeky studio hop. There are tons of amazing, amazing people part of this hop, and the spring is theme. I'm actually using some old cheeky studio product that I've had in my stash for quite a while, and I know I should be scrapbooking, but I still do not have any scrapbooking mojo whatsoever. So I'm doing a really quick art journal spread in my B6 mixed media notebook. And you can see I have some definite warping on this left-hand side of my book. And I'm okay with that. I think it just gives the page more character. So I have a layer of gesso on the page and I'm just quickly drying it. It's only one coat and it's gonna dry fairly quickly. You see where some of that paint leaked through on the bottom of the page? It's all good because you won't even notice it by the time I'm done with this page. I chose four colors to work with. They were Payne's Gray, which I absolutely love, an ultramarine violet, phthalo blue, and a fluorescent pink. Now, the fluorescent colors never do what I want them to do because they're just very, very transparent. So unless you're using them on their own, they don't give me what I'm looking for. But that's okay. I was really happy with the way it all ended up turning out and looking. So here I'm spreading the Payne's Gray first because it is my darkest color. With something like this, I'm going to go with the darkest first. There's no really rhyme or reason. It's just the dark colors on top of the light colors are obviously going to cover them up. So I started with the dark, and then from the Payne's Gray, I went to the ultramarine violet. And when I started this, I truly had no idea what my plan was in mind. I just kind of went for it. I had to go grab a different paintbrush because I didn't want to use that same paintbrush for the violet. So I grabbed this cheap paintbrush from Michael's. I think I got like a pack for like $6 and it was perfect. So I blended in the Payne's Gray and the violet here, and you can see me just adding some more color. I'm always a less is more kind of girl when I'm putting paint down on my palette. For the simple fact, I can always add more, but you know, I never know if I can really get that paint used up before it dries, because acrylic paint will dry fairly quickly. So after the paint, the Payne's Gray, the ultramarine violet, then I went over to my phthalo blue, and this is a new paint for me. I've never tried this brand before. But a few weekends ago when I went to Michael's, it was buy one, get one free. And I was like, can't pass that up. So it was like $7 for the tube. And then I got another tube for free, which really worked out for me. And I really like it. It's a heavy body, but it's not super heavy body. And I'm really impressed with it. It's Grumbacher Academy, I believe. Anyways, I really like it. It was worth the $7. The tube of paint will last me forever, as most of my paints do. So yes, they're an investment to buy the better quality paints, but they really last a long time. Especially for somebody like me that only gets to art journal, you know, once or twice a week. I finally just ran out of my titanium white. Well, that actually happened to be the other color that I grabbed from the buy one, get one free deal, was a titanium white. And not that you needed to know that was just my thing here. Let me mention that the next place on the hop is going to be actually Cheeky Studio, and it appears that it's going to be their website. I'm not sure, but it's not a YouTube link. And also that if you used guest 10 at checkout on the Cheeky Studio site, you can grab some awesome die cuts at 10% off. And let me tell you, her die cuts are so awesome and so amazing. And the vibrancy of the colors that come with each die cut is really, really impressive. I love them. I need to definitely grab some of the new ones that she just released, especially the gamer one, because I have a family of gamers. So for sure I need those gamer die cuts. So I'm just layering them here. These are my focal point on my spread, and I am layering them in a way that they just kind of take up the middle of the page, and they bring all of the paint colors together in a sense. And then, I know me. There was no way I was ever gonna get these back to this way if I took them off and then tried to lay them back on the page. So I literally, as you can see me, and I left this part in just so you could see what I did. I stuck my glue into areas, lifted up a piece, and then slapped it back down. Because there was just, I'm just one of those people that I could lay it out and I love it, and then I move it, and then it doesn't look the way that it was before when I loved it. So I was really trying to keep everything kind of in place so that I wouldn't end up hating my project. After I got everything glued down, and you can see this area here did not want to stick down for me whatsoever. After I got everything glued down, I'm gonna come in with that hot pink or fluorescent pink, whatever you wanna call it. And I'm just gonna kind of add some accent colors to it. And that's it. I add my word stickers from Tim Holtz, and I call this spread done. So I really hope you enjoyed this hop. I really definitely say go check out the Cheeky Studio. And if you need some traveler's notebooks, you know where to find me over at rockyournotebook.com. I really love working in my mixed media traveler's notebooks just because they're small. So I'm not intimidated by this huge blank slate of paper. I kind of can just go with it and go with the flow and be creative. Alrighty, that is it for me and my video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if this is your first time to my channel, I welcome you and hope you'll subscribe. Alrighty, bye-bye.